Hello and welcome to my course on effects. In this series of videos, I try my best to go through and explain different aspects of this amazing library. To get the most out of this course, I recommend 1 to 2 years of experience coding. The effect library is built for TypeScript, so familiarity with TypeScript is a prerequisite. Effect is also designed in functional paradigm. So I recommend to go through and watch my course on functional programming in TypeScript, which I will link it in the description. With no further ado, let's get into it. So what is effect? Effect is a TypeScript library providing environments to create robust and scalable applications using functional programming concepts. Now the question is, what is functional programming? Why it is important, and how much of it do we need to know to be able to use effect? Functional programming is a way to think and design your solution to your problem. You're probably already familiar with object-oriented programming or procedural programming in which you're using variables and mutate them until you get to the result you're expecting. This is what is known as imperative paradigm in coding. Functional programming is different in a way that instead of mutating any states in your application, you define transformations declaratively and chain them together to solve your problem. As the name suggests, functions are in the center of our designs in functional programming. Functions are used to model our algorithms, but they also treated as values and can be passed around. How does it work? You first break your problem into smaller, simpler functions, and by composing and combining those functions, you get closer and closer to your desired solution. And while doing this, you are not mutating anything. Functional programming is simply mapping of inputs to outputs. Functional programming is not about a programming language, but it's a way of solving your problems. So no matter what language you use, if that language can treat functions as values, you're good to go. Let's take a closer look at functions in functional programming. I like to think of functions as pipes. They receive an input from one side and return an output from the other side. They are simply mappings from input to output. This mapping should be total, meaning for each possible input value, there should be an output value. They also should be predictable, meaning we cannot have an input value mapped to two output values. For each input value, there should be only one output value. Functions are contained, meaning they have everything they need to do their computation. In other words, they have no side effects, like fetching something from internet, or writing to a file, or even logging to a console. Then you may ask, how can functions be useful if we cannot do side effects? We will see how effect library handles side effects. But having these limitations have extremely useful outcomes. So useful that such functions have a name. We call them pure functions. Simply what all of these mean is, functions in functional programming are simply transformations. That's why I think pipes are good analogies for them. The most important outcome of function purity is these functions are free to be used in any context. You can easily move them, use them, and refactor them without being worried about breaking your application. The other useful outcome is we can compose and use them with other pure functions to create new pure functions with exactly the same benefits. I think you see where I'm going with this. By repeating this process of composing and combining pure functions, we get closer and closer to our program, which will be a big pure function ready to receive inputs to give us outputs. Imagine how robust, scalable, and testable such a program can be. And this is what effect promises. Effect abstracts and tools around foundational concepts in functional programming like functors, applicatives, monads, either IO, task, and provide us with an easy, more practical, and safer environment to solve problems we are dealing with in our day-to-day projects. Effect brings the benefits of functional programming to our TypeScript projects without requiring deep knowledge of foundational functional programming concepts and techniques. Effect is inspired by an existing project written in Scala called Zio. And coming from the creators of Zio, Effect will have a lot of impact. Coding in Effect is a bit different from what you may be used to. Honestly, it can be a bit daunting at first. But once you grasp the mindset behind it and learn how to think and design with it, you will not only end up with solid and quality applications, but you will also become extremely productive. When you get comfortable, code written with Effect is pretty readable. One of the key benefits of coding with Effect is it unifies synchronous and asynchronous code, making them look similar for seamless, readable, and maintainable programming. Effect is packed with tools, making it easier to handle most day-to-day coding needs. Things like error handling, resource management, observability, scheduling, caching, and so on. Effect library is centered around a data type called quote-unquote effect. Let's take a quick look at effect data type. Effect represents an idea of computation, a computation that may have side effects. Effect can be stored in a constant or passed around as a function parameter, just like any other values. Effects are intended to be run eventually, and the library is providing us with tools to do that. Here I'm simplifying things a little bit, but the idea is the same. When running an instance of an effect, we want our computation complete successfully and give us an output of some type A. But things may not always go in the right direction when we do computations. The computation may also errors out, and effect captures that as some type E. For example, if our computation is dividing two numbers, the return value could be either a number such as 0.5 when the computation finishes successfully, or a string indicating an error if we are dividing by zero. No more throwing unknown exceptions in our functions. This means when we're coding, not only we are considering the happy path of our code, we also need to consider the error path. It means if our code compiles, it probably works as expected. This is already a super useful construct and it can increase the quality of our day-to-day coding. But in reality, our computations still need one more thing to model any kind of computation in practice. Sometimes our computation depends on some external code or library. These dependencies and requirements can be shown by this R type parameter. R represents all the requirements our computation depends on. Getting back to our dividing function example, let's say our computation is getting the inputs from a database. Then our R type parameter here would be, for example, DB, which is probably an interface with some database related methods like query. If our function also requires to log messages to some central log system, then we can add that along with the DB. But wait a second. Didn't we say we want our functions and computations to be pure with no side effects? Then how come querying a database and logging are considered pure? Well, the trick is, when we are creating effects, we are not actually executing the side effects inside them. By using effect type, we are postponing the execution of those side effects until we actually run our effects. It's like when we are coding an effect, we are writing an instruction of how our application should work. We are only creating the transformations and pipes. No water goes through the pipes yet. But by leveraging and relying heavily on our type system, we can predict so much in advance without needing to actually execute our effects. And this is how effect deals with side effects. Before we can actually execute our effect, we need to provide an implementation for each dependency our effect has. By doing so, we remove these requirements and dependencies, ultimately creating an effect with no requirements. And at this point, our effect is ready to run. In the following videos, we will learn how to create effect instances, how to transform them, compose and combine them into new ones, and how to run them. But till then, thank you for watching this video. Please like and subscribe, and I will see you in the next one.